Hello, everyone, and welcome to week 43 of RollPlay Solum. It's time to find out what everyone's been up to before we get to the actual show. Jeff, I'm going to start with you. We got to talk Furious 7.
Oh, God.
What do you think of the movie?
All right.
And also, should we spoilers? Are we going to talk about the entire movie?
Minor spoiler.
Minor spoilers, okay.
Yeah, you can't. If you're going to a Furious 7 movie and you actually care about anything that could be spoiler related, then you're going for the wrong fucking reasons. You probably should be, you know, detained.
Sure.
My favorite part, the part that everyone's like, suspend disbelief. I'm like, yeah, okay, I'll try.
I know where you're going.
Do you?
Does it have to do with some towers?
No, that's the obvious picture.
Oh, okay, that's the obvious.
Mine's the subtle hipster one.
Okay.
There is a Predator drone chasing a car underneath the road.
Oh, you're talking,
tunnel.
Yeah.
Now, The Rock is driving an ambulance a floor above, no phone, no radar, nothing. And I fucking kid you not, he's driving, and he goes, aah! And he crashes it over the side of the road and hits the Predator before it can kill the car beneath. The Predator's going 100 miles per hour. He's going 100 miles per hour. He can't see it. It's beneath him. They're not talking, guys. It's not possible. And if it were possible by dumb luck, he also would not be screaming because he knows it's going to hit it. That's the whole fucking movie, all right? Like, and I'm here, and there's like, by the way, there's like some of the worst jokes ever in the crowd we were with. We're the biggest seven fans.
I hate
it. It sold out the five showings before. We had to go to the fifth one. And they're like something terrible. They're like, that is so Furious. it's a great time. It's a great time if you don't mind the fact that it's a horrible movie. Like, I had an existential crisis where I'm looking around at people around me and I'm like, this is the movie that's selling out theaters across the fucking planet. Like,
yeah.
And people are missing out on really good movies, and they don't care. They're seeing Furious 7. It's weird, man.
It was fantastic. It's weird. I loved every. I had a smile on my face the entire movie. Just
the
because
the Ronda Rousey scene was cool.
No, that was the worst scene in the entire movie. When she opened her mouth and tried to act, I actually cringed. Like, I had to turn away from the fucking film.
The best part about the movie, the redeeming quality for the movie for me, was I actually think they did an amazing job of giving a nod to Paul Walker. I thought that was really cool.
That was
he was an
well
integral
done.
Part of the series, so I think it's like I've seen every Furious 7 movie except for Tokyo Drift, because even as a child I was smart enough to know.
No, that's the best
that
one.
Fucking, no,
it's the best movie.
If I bet,
it's the best Furious movie by far.
By Furious standards, yes, I suppose. If you're looking for the worst things to have ever happened in movie,
it's the best. It's got the best story. It's got the hottest women in it. It's got the best lead actor who's not like this giant muscly guy. He's just a fucking nerd kid. It's good.
Two things to fire off. One, Vin Diesel he's finally hit that age where he has to either do steroids like The Rock, or he's going to look like he does now, which is a fairly buff middle-aged man who's been too much tanning.
Yeah, his jowls are also getting a little bit loose. Like,
and he tucks in his chin a lot of scenes, but this is amazing because to me, and this transformed the film for me, I really enjoyed it after this, I realized if you think of him as a human caricature of a hot dog come to life, the movie has new levels of joy. Every That's time true. He came on, I was like, it's a hot dog. And Anna literally leaned over and said, you are ruining the experience for me. Stop. So I did have to stop, but he does look like an animated hot dog.
Yeah.
Also, they finished the film. Obviously, Paul Walker died during the filming. So some of it's CGI and some of it's his brother.
That was impressive. Actually. I didn't realize that it was CGI at the very end.
I never caught it, except for at the very end.
When he smiled?
He's driving. When he turns and smiles.
Yeah.
His eyes look fucking horrified. Do not ever CGI anyone, dead or alive, ever. Yeah. He's like, he looks at him and he's like, like, just the most intense eyes ever. And it's like, no. That's, I'm sure that's not what he looks like, because I saw him for the rest of the movie. That's horrifying.
Yeah. The funny part for me, too, was the lead actor from Tokyo Drift. Like, they had the scene in there from Tokyo Drift. It was the actual footage from the movie. And then they spliced in a scene with him afterwards, and he just magically aged, like, 10 years. Like, he's just 10 years older in the actual movie. I thought that was pretty funny, too. But overall, good movie. I enjoyed it.
I mean, again, if your expectations are in the right place, then yes.
If you go, yeah, if you go into that movie expecting, like, an amazing narrative, you're fucking up. If you go into that movie expecting, like, over-the-top bullshit action with really bad one-liners that are actually hilarious because of how bad they are, and just stupidity on every level, it's the best movie of all time. And that's what I went in with, so I was very pleased with it.
And this is, by the way, the non-spoilers. There's even something else to be more upset about, again, if you're measuring it to the standards of a real movie. But we will not spoil that. But yes, definitely, like JP said, go see it and expect shit. Shit at the highest degrees to the point where it's funny.
Fantastic. I love the movie. Did you do anything else over the weekend?
Yeah. This weekend we did the Mortal Kombat 10 launch.
Oh, yeah. I watched you guys. That's right.
Yeah. It was really fun. It never ceases to amaze me, the people that are on the internet. Every time I'm exposed to a new community, like, the people that I haven't blocked yet come out and tweet at me, and it's like, oh, fuck, there they are. Like,
yeah.
One guy's like, I can't believe you were making jokes while a pro football player was in the same room as you. And I was like, on so many levels, just like, whoa.
Well, he's a baseball player.
He's a baseball player. Yeah. Jokes are disrespectful in humanity, I guess. I don't know. I wasn't even making fun of him. He didn't like that I was making jokes in his presence. Like, it was...
That's kind of weird.
It was amazing. These people exist, and they play Mortal Kombat. But otherwise, the game's actually, like... I didn't get paid for it, by the way, so let me just say that because it's actually a fucking incredible game.
Yeah, I really want to play the story mode next week.
Yes!
The story mode's going to be
really good. I never get so much playability out of fighter games. I was telling them this because playing online's pretty shit. I don't have friends that I invite over.
Same here.
I don't go to the house. So I play it for, like, a week, and it's not because I don't like it, but it's like,
That's why I want to play story mode. And the test your luck mode looks really fun and stupid.
Oh.
And I might play that with
friends. Did you see our damn it thing that we did?
Yeah, where it's the strobe light thing and the portals on the ground, yeah. That'll be a fun, like, party Twitch game,
yes.
I think.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. Like, online there's some viability there, but, like, if you have friends coming over doing... Because that was just what we made on the fly. There's going to be better ones.
Yeah.
And you can make some stupid shit that is just so funny.
It looks really good. Yeah. It looks really good. Cool. It sounds like you had an eventful weekend.
I did. A little
Furious 7. By the way, did you get the plot of the movie? They're furious, and there's seven of them. Because of what happens in the movie, you know? They're upset. And there's seven of them. I left the movies thinking that, and I was like, that movie's awesome. From start to finish.
I just can't wait for the next one.
Yeah, Furious 8's going to be great.
It's going to be a great ton.
I love it.
Oh my God.
Ryan, you're not usually up at these hours. You could tell so by the darkness in your entire face.
He's wearing a robe.
Yeah, and the fact that there's actually light coming through my windows.
Yeah.
That's a rare thing on my street.
You don't have blinds on those windows, do you?
No, my girlfriend asked me if I want them, and I always say no because it's always nighttime, right? So there's no real reason, but yeah, do not have them.
What have you been up to?
This Friday was Passover,
mm-hmm.
and so we celebrated Passover this weekend. A bunch of people flew in from Israel, and we all hung out with all those people and did the whole, like, Passover thing. I don't really understand all of the Hebrew that's being said when we do it, but it's always a good time. So we did that, and then on Sunday we had Easter, and we did an adult Easter egg hunt, which
I
always
put money in the eggs.
Amazing, yes.
Okay, then I'm interested.
This is how we do the adult Easter egg hunt. Each person has a color of egg, right? You have, like, your own color. So we take all of the egg, or the parents take all the eggs and they hide them in the back, and there's money in them, and it can be like anywhere between, like, $1 and $20.
Okay.
So the rule is you go back in the backyard and you find all of the eggs of your color. And once you found your eggs, there's five eggs. Once you found all five of yours, you get to run to the front yard and find the Spider-Man eggs. And those are the money eggs, and those have $100 per egg.
Damn.
Yeah, so it's like an adult Easter egg hunt, and it's
and then they start fighting.
Ah! Oh yeah, there's like alliances. You know, people are like, "I'll tell you where your egg is if you tell me where mine is." There's like a whole, like, survivor thing going on. So I usually make alliances and try to do that, but I had to leave early this year.
So how much money did you end up with?
Well, like I said, I had to leave early, so I found four of my eggs first.
Mm-hmm.
And then, so my girlfriend's parents were coming over to our house that night. So I found four of my eggs, which totaled up to like, I don't know, $80 or something. And, then I just said, you know, we gotta go. So my parents, who hid the eggs, couldn't find my last egg in the backyard. So there's still like $20 in the backyard somewhere. I don't know.
Interesting.
Yeah, but some people definitely walked away with more than I did.
Are you sure it wasn't the... You sure your parents aren't assholes? And they're like, oh yeah, we lost the fifth egg. I wonder what happened to it.
Yeah, what could have happened?
Yeah.
Yeah, but... so we went back to my place and we were hosting my girlfriend's parents. And for some reason, my girlfriend was like, let's play Cards of Humanity with my parents.
That's not a good idea.
No, never.
Yeah.
Nope, you fell into that trap.
Yeah.
Once.
So I was like, okay, but I've played Cards of Humanity a bunch, so the stuff in the game doesn't really...
You gotta get the expansions, yeah.
Yeah, it like doesn't shock me anymore to play that game, so I have to create my own shocking moments.
Sure.
So last night, you know, I just played a little bit before I streamed. So last night, I'm playing the black card. Like, I'm the guy, you know, reading the card. And it's like the National Museum of History just opened up an exhibit on blank. And everybody turns in their cards. And I flip them all over and I start reading them. And just to, like, create some tension or awkwardness, somebody played a card. And I read it out loud. And I'm like, the National Museum of History just opened up an exhibit on the clitoris. And then I say... I look at my girlfriend's mom and I say, "What is that?" Just to try and like,
oh my god,
to make it more
the balls right now, Ryan. I'm impressed. I'm impressed,
dude. I gotta, you know, like pump it up somehow. And,
yeah, you're gonna find out stuff you don't want to know. Though is the thing.
Exactly. So what? I'm dying to know what happened.
She was just very embarrassed and didn't answer me, but it was. I just thought it was hilarious. So.
My mom played a Bukkake card once, and my brother dared to ask her. He said, "You don't know what that is, do you?" And she actually did not, thank God.
Mm. Nice.
But yeah, so this weekend, it was just a bunch of family time hanging out. It was pretty awesome.
Family time, playing, asking your girlfriend's mom. What a clitoris.
Yes, I mean, you gotta do something.
What?
I gotta spice it up somehow.
There you go. There you go. Neil, it sounds like you're killing mosquitoes.
No, not yet.
Is there a spider? I got a spider bro now. He's somewhere up in the attic.
Oh, I would love a spider bro to eat these motherfuckers.
Yeah. Yeah, he watches me shower every day. Or I think.
I'd love to watch you shower, too.
That's weird. I don't know where he's at, though. I haven't seen him in days. No, what else have you been up to?
Spider bro.
What death-defying thing have you done this past 2 weeks? Or week? I don't know when we last played. A week. Two?
It's been a while. I don't know how long.
I don't either.
How
have you died recently? Or how have you almost died?
No dying things. Just good Indian food that gives you, you know, that doesn't burn on the way down, but lets you know that you've cleared your entire system.
Uh-huh.
That was lovely.
Nice. Nice. What else have you been up to?
It was my wife's birthday, which was on April Fool's Day.
Oh, yeah. You went to islands.
Went to Kappa Islands, which were... pretty awesome.
Kappa
little kayaking up there.
Kappa.
Kappa Islands?
Great. You mean Kappa. Grayface Island?
Grayface How do you Island? Spell that? K-A-P-P-A?
C-A-T space B-A. Kappa.
K-A-P-P-A.
Jesus, this place looks luxurious as fuck, and it's probably cheap as shit.
Yeah. Yeah. Hotel rooms range from expensive being $7 to cheap being $2 a night.
What the fuck?
What?
Kappa Island.
Yeah. Yeah. You gotta walk up to the fifth floor, but you know, whatever. $7 a night for a hotel room in that place, y'all take it.
That's kinda Jeff, have you seen did you Google pictures of this place? You should.
No.
I'll just link it to you. Because for link. $7 a night, I think I'd go to this place.
Well it's pretty nice.
How long was the travel to get there? I'm curious because it's all islands.
An hour, 45 minutes from my house.
$7 a night.
That's not bad.
No, it's like a weekend place for us. We can just pop out whenever we want. So that's pretty cool.
It's not bad.
Pretty cool. Made a whole bunch of friends in the the kayaking and rock climbing community up there.
Nice.
So we can head over whenever we want. And then for Easter, I made an Easter egg hunt for my wife because there's no other U.S. traditions here. Or
when you say kayak and rock climbing community, do you just mean white people?
There's shades. You know, some of them get outdoors a lot.
I think I got you. You met the other white people, didn't you?
Mostly it is other white people, yeah. But there are a few non-whites over there.
Yeah.
But yeah, that industry is definitely predominantly...
Okay. Sorry. But, go ahead.
But you get shades.
You're so politically correct, Jeff.
I just love it when tourists be like, we met these other people over there in that community. We made friends. Like, you mean the other white people that you found on your travels? Yeah, they're the other white people.
Okay. All right, well, so I went out trying to find maple syrup the other day, and I had a shop in mind that I thought the maple syrup was at because a friend had told me that this shop had it once upon a time. So I go out to find this legendary maple syrup, and it's too far to walk, so I just hop on the back of some guy's motorbike and be like, take me to this street, and we, you know, because that's how you do it. You just hop on the back of a bike and direct them somewhere. And we get around, and we're going up and down the street, and we can't find this maple syrup. And I pull up a Google image picture of what maple syrup is to make sure that he knows what it is, and we're looking at these shops, and it's not there. So eventually he pulls over and starts chatting in Vietnamese to these other people. And they start directing him down this alleyway. And as he turns down the alleyway, he just mumbles a word. I don't even know what word it was, or maybe it was two words. And the person that is walking past us as we're going down this alleyway just points casually behind them. He does it again when we come to another person who points at a door. And he comes to a stop in front of this door and starts pointing at the door and saying, you know, what I presume to be, go talk to these people. Except to take a look at the house, and it's the house of our two friends, the two other white people that live here. He literally took me to the only other white people in the entire neighborhood, being like, I don't know what you want. Talk to these people. These people will help you. Not knowing that they're my friends.
Wait. So was he asking the other people on the road, like, have you seen the two other white people?
Yes. He was asking them, where do the closest white people live? Oh, and then I got directed to my friend's house and told to go talk to them. And when I was like, no, they're not home, he took me to a hotel where the concierge spoke English and then was prompted like, no, I have no idea what this is or where I can find this.
Interesting.
Yeah, that was fun.
So what was... Like,
that was Monday.
Yeah, that was Monday. Maple syrup, and there was something else that you were trying to find, but you had a hard time.
Oh, God, so many things.
What if you just opened up a store with these oddities and became like a Vietnamese king?
Unless you are Vietnamese, you are not allowed to own property or businesses.
Oh, really? Well, that's how they keep the white man down over there.
Keeping the white man down.
Something nasty.
Yeah.
What if you pay a Vietnamese person to open up a place for you and have them run it as a shell company and really you sell maple syrup?
That's done very, very frequently. I just don't think there's a big call for maple syrup in this part of Vietnam.
Well, they don't know what they're missing.
You're telling me, man.
Yeah,
man, we could do a deal. I can help you with the maple syrup.
Yeah? All right. I think a maple syrup dispenser would be great.
Here we go. We're going to open up a store called RollPlay's Oddities. Jen's going to be the main supplier. Neil's going to run the store and going to find the Vietnamese person. Jeff and Ryan can just be the word of mouth. I don't know what else you guys
can
do.
We'll get it out there.
Ryan can run the books. We'll do that. He's on Vietnamese time anyways. Yeah. We'll have Ryan run the books. and then, I don't know.
Jeff does our advertisements.
Yeah, he can be the model for holding the maple syrup.
I may embezzle the books a little bit.
Jeff also could serve as our bouncer if someone we don't want in the store walks in. We can just have him toss him.
Yeah, I'm down with all this.
We're doing it.
Can you give yourself like a little lumberjack look? I feel like it would help for our brand.
We're doing it. There you go.
It's working.
Solved. Coming to you 2016.
That's been my week in Vietnam.
Nice. What? Anything exciting coming up for you? You going to Cap?
We have our new internet line coming tomorrow or the day after because there's translation issues. But one of these days coming up soon, we're actually going to have our own dedicated line so the internet will stop being a piece of shit.
What was that, like $13? How much did that cost?
I think for 30 down and up, it should be like $25.
It's not bad.
No, it's not bad.
Is that considered a luxury over there? That sounds kind of expensive compared to the $7 hotel.
No, I think normally that would be that line would be split between like an entire community. So if I'm taking it for myself, then it will be luxury.
There you go. There you go. Moving on up, Neil. Well, let us know how that goes. Last but not least, Jen turned 25 yesterday. Happy belated birthday.
Thank you.
What?
I am now a quarter of a century old.
Yep. You're a year,
still well, the youngest on the show, Jen.
I'm not I am now closer to 30 than to 25. No, than to 20.
By a couple days, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's happening.
Well, by like by 11 hours or
Jen, me too.
13 hours. Ryan, you're already.
I'm also closer to 30 than I am to 20.
Yeah. Ryan, you got 1 year left. You got to like live it up, man, because it's going to shit soon.
What do you mean? I'm already 30.
And he's like, he has coffee mug at 2-3 p.m. He's
It's happening sooner than I thought.
No, I've just gotten to give no fucks. My coffee mug says coffee chocolate mint, and I just don't care. Like, I just, whatever, man.
Nice. Jim, what'd you do for your birthday?
Friday, I went out with coworkers. Got pretty drunk. Like, I don't usually get that drunk, but they kept buying me shooters. It kind of worked out.
Shots.
So I was like,
shots. No. Okay.
Yeah. Sorry. In French, we say shooters for some reason.
It's all right. Everyone can be wrong once.
Yeah. So I was like tumbling back to my house going it was nice. And then Saturday morning, brunch with the family to follow it up nicely, yeah?
That's always smart.
So I had to get up early and my brother picked me up. We had a really nice brunch and then we played Catan.
Settlers. Yeah. Fuck that game.
And we actually managed to get into a massive family fight.
Yes.
Of course.
People won't trade, man. Real? They're bogarting the sheep and stuff.
I know. It was so funny.
Was it real?
I'm like, huh?
Were people actually upset?
Well, my two younger cousins, who are like 14 and 16, brother and sister, they started screaming at each other, calling themselves like cow and whatever.
Damn.
Yeah.
Some family, so like, some good old fashioned family drama.
Yeah, we still finished the game though, and I won.
Nice.
And like, my uncle really wanted my little cousins to win because they're younger and whatnot, and I was like, oh, fuck this.
Gotta earn that.
Oh, yeah, I don't do any prisoners or nice things to, like, it's not because you're younger that you're gonna get a free pass. I'm so with this. Like, I'm cutting their roads, I'm like, crushing their dreams, sending my thief. Yeah. Yeah, so I won. And Saturday night, I went out with some girlfriends. It was nice to, like, childhood girlfriends. What else can I talk about? Oh, I got some gifts. Mm-hmm. My mom bought me a Taylor Swift CD, which is here.
Nice. Ooh, Taylor Swift. That's a good one.
I know you
like it. 6 months ago.
Yeah, I finally got it. And Jean Leloup, which is like a local guy who makes really good music.
That's a dog. You listen to a dog sing, apparently.
Oof, oof. Yeah. What else? I got rain boots, shoes, a luggage case thing from my brother. Useful shit, really.
That's what happens when you get older. You just get useful shit, not fun stuff.
Yeah. I got a gift from Poker Stars.
They give you a deck of cards?
No, it's really cool. There's my face on it.
That's sick.
That is awesome.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah. It says, thanks for taking part. You can bet your bottom dollar we'll be in touch. Signed, Poker Stars Touch. The puns.
Wow.
Puns are
you keep making pew-pew sounds, Jeff. Is this your new thing?
I don't know.
Well, when you work on the Rainbow Six team, Jeff, it's actually in the contract.
She's like, I got drunk. I got cards. I'm like, God, that office. Everyone's like, we're making a game.
Good morning, 25. Everyone.
Yeah, on the PA, that's how they open it up at the office.
They're all just like, you just see fingers above their little dividers.
Yeah, they say hi to people, you don't shake hands, you just do the finger guns.
Wasn't weird until I did it on the internet and everyone noticed and all I say is pew pew.
Oh, God. Anything else, Jen?
Well, tomorrow, the Rainbow Six Alpha is starting. Mm-hmm. And I know a lot of people have been asking, and it is actually written in the FAQ, but for some reason people are not reading my FAQ, so go
I don't even know where that's at.
Yeah, I don't
but yeah, no NDAs, So expect a lot of streams and YouTube videos.
There you
and
go.
Maybe people from this group might be streaming it. Maybe.
Well, if there's no, I'll be streaming it tomorrow. There's no NDA, so I'll be streaming it tomorrow.
So watch JP become a tactical shooter man.
Yep, I'm gonna spam the walls. Be the best.
Hey, don't do that.
What is what you do in the game? You just shoot the walls. I've seen it. I watched all the videos. I'm
you
a pro
can
now.
Definitely kill people through walls.
Yep.
Really nice.
Yep. All right, cool. That's what everyone's been up to. Neil, we last left off in your dungeon where I opened a door hastily because I wanted to watch Ezekiel's roast, and you killed me, or did damage to me, so I'm at, like, 5 HP.
Well, fair part about that was Neil arguing for the, like, no, no, wait, let's just, it'll take 2 more minutes. JP's like, fine, I open a door. He's like, okay, a rock hits me, roll for damage. Like,
yeah,
like, what? Like
yeah.
That was a fun moment for me.
Yeah.
No, by the way, before... Off camera, I leveled. Well, on camera I leveled, and then I picked something off camera, I believe.
Mm.
We should talk about that now, right, Neil?
Yeah.
Why don't you talk about that, Jeff?
What'd you get?
I need to see if I wrote it down.
Also, did you roll for your HP?
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, I did. I didn't roll very well for that. My total HP now is 47. Well, oh, no. It was less than 47, but I got to pick a feat at level, what am I, 4?
Yeah.
Level 4, and you get a feat once in a blue moon. And I picked,
I don't even remember.
God, I hope I wrote it down. Hang on. Oh, no, I did tough. So, what happens with tough is I get level times 2 more health when taken. Oh.
So you
plus
get
2 each level.
Yeah, so you got 8 more HP, and then every level you get an additional 2 HP.
Yeah. So what's your total HP now?
47.
Damn.
I figured because when I'm raging and I get 3
of
those.
Yeah, no, you're a good tank now.
I'm a hell of a good tank. Yeah, I take half damage and I should be getting more health each time. So
yeah.
Figure it'll help. They were pretty cool though. A lot of those were insane. I could have became a spellcaster like on a minor level, of course. And there was one where like when I charge, I do times 2 damage and shit like that. It was pretty insane.
Nice.
No, I thought I was the tank now.
You are. You revealed that.
Yeah, that's true. You revealed that you can tank last episode. That's true.
Yeah.
All right. Where did we... We left off by looting that room. And I think we're still in the room.
Yes.
Oh, I had something written out. Magical item in the chest, Neil.
Yes, there is a magical item in the chest.
Wait,
there are 3 chests.
Okay. Continue.
Stacked side by side.
They are the prisoner's chests, yes.
Let's take a look. In the chest that is emitting a slight magical aura from the outside of the chest. Once the chest is open, the magical aura intensifies dramatically. And there at the base of the chest, sitting over a satin cloth that is draped over a small pedestal, is a glass ball. About the size of 2 hands cupped one
I
over
broke
the other.
It,
JP, you know what to do.
No, I kind of put my arms out. I'm just like, no one touch it.
Well, I'm the one looking at it right now, right?
Yeah. Well, I guess everyone is kind of gathered around. You already chatted with the woman who was in bed, who is just hanging out over there now. So the 4 of you are crowded around this chest as Jen produces this orb from it.
Yeah. Can I know which type of magic it is? Because I have Detect Magic on right now, right?
Is that part of the Detect Magic spell?
I think so. Let me read it.
What was the woman's name, by the way?
You sense presence of magic, blah, 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 aura, according to how magical it is.
Her name was Serena.
Serena, okay.
You learn a school of magic, if any. That's what
divination.
Divination. Ooh, how convenient. Mm-hmm. So I guess I hold it up and I'm like, my friends, we have found something of great value. It is a magical item of divination. And then I kind of do like...
I turn to Serena and say, do you know anything about this?
She shakes her head slowly and then says, he never really let me play with anything. I was pretty much just... Well, his play toy.
And this was the orc chieftain that we killed?
Uh-huh.
Did you see him play with this thing?
No, he mostly just left it in there, occasionally, from time to time, taking it out and looking at it on the table, she says, pointing to the table across from you guys. But I've never really seen him do anything with it other than look at it.
Did he tend to say something when he was looking at it? Like a specific word that he would repeat over and over again?
No, he mostly just sat there looking bored and frustrated. It seemed to bother him. I don't think he could figure out how to use it.
Well, maybe I can figure it out.
What does it do?
I just know it's for divination, so it's not a harmful thing. I would think it can be used to know stuff. Find out stuff. Look into stuff.
Did you miss the mosquito?
I missed another mosquito. I hate these
dengue fever.
Yeah. Sorry,
so the
had it once, don't need to have it again.
I know, I shouldn't joke about that, actually. I'm sorry.
Do you guys mind if I hold on to it to study it further?
Can you study it now?
Neil, I need identify, right, to do that?
Can't you make...
Yes. Well, we're going to scrap the rules for magic identification that come natively in 5e. I think it's a little bit too easy. It takes away all the mystery and all the fun.
I don't even know if identify was in the list of spells I could learn, like, ever, though. It might not be in 5th.
Yeah, I think, doesn't 5th use arcana checks as identifying?
I think you have to attune yourself to the item just by, like, hanging on to it and playing with it for a little bit.
So can I just do that? Like, play with it every day?
No. We're scrapping those rules. Okay. You'd need an identify spell, or you'd need to do research into it and try and figure out what type of... what it might be.
Okay, like at the library or something like that, maybe?
Yeah. Or you'd need to talk to... probably talk to some sort of scholar who knows such things about magic items. Probably a wizard, or a sage, or a scholar, or someone that is involved in magic-related materials.
Okay. Because I don't know if there is actually an identify spell. Is it?
I don't know.
Because if it's a normal ability, then there would
not
be...
You can only identify with an identify spell, but the spell's not in the game.
No, it's there, apparently. But I don't think it's a level 1 spell, but it wasn't in my options to choose it, as far
you
as...
You are what class are you? You're a wizard?
I'm a wizard, yeah.
Neil, it's while right this there. Is going on, I spy some bananas on the table. I want to just eat one while we're chilling.
All right. You eat a banana. Give me a constitution saving throw.
Are they ripe? They look ripe in the picture.
Yeah, they look ripe.
Okay. Ah, yes!
The banana is fucking delicious, dude. Yes. It's good.
Sorry.
There are still two other chests besides the one that held the orb.
Yeah, I go up and check them for traps and all that stuff.
The smaller chest on the left, none of them had any traps that you could find.
Okay.
The smaller chest on the left holds a few thousand copper and just shy of 1,000 silver.
Okay. What is 1,000 copper?
Like,
or I'm sorry, how much you said? Just a few thousand. What is the exact number? Like, I sit there and count it out.
You count out about 6,000 copper coins and 730 silver coins.
So 60 gold and 73 silver.
730
gold. 73 gold.
Yeah, 73 gold plus if you carry all the copper with you, an additional 60 gold.
How small is the smallest chest in here, and can it carry all of the?
All the coins are already in the smallest chest.
And would that be easier than transporting it in our bags?
Yeah. If you're going to take all of them, I would take it in the chest.
Okay. I toss it over to Karn. Say, like, make sure you keep that close.
Did someone write down the numbers, or should I write down the numbers?
I've wrote it down. It's 60 gold and 73 gold if you just want to put it on your character sheet.
That's right. Small chest. Karn doesn't count, so you know. How much does it weigh, Neil?
Let's see. Let me do some quick math. divided by 50 pounds. It weighs 135 pounds.
Luckily, you don't have armor, so you can wear that, right, Jeff?
I can.
Yeah.
I am the middle encumbrance or whatever.
Okay. So you're slightly slow to hauling this.
Yeah.
I'm super slow, though, so I guess it doesn't matter.
And in the third chest, well, you have a raccoon to ride on.
Yeah.
The third chest contains a bunch of silk garments and a couple of very fine bottles of wine.
Ooh, this looks delicious.
Can you describe the silk garments? I take them out and, like, dust them off.
They are sized for humans, but they are, they're silk shirts and pants and a robe and a vest, a couple pairs of silk boxer briefs.
How much would this fetch to sell?
Give me... You're a rogue, right?
Yes.
So why don't you just give me an intelligence check?
Okay.
Is there a small covering?
Excuse me?
I mean, what a, Neil, I can see
guys,
the silk.
The 20 is real right now.
Let me check something.
Don't roll it. Don't. Oh! You wasted it. Well, you saved
it. No, I got it out of the way, bro.
Yeah, you got it out of the way.
It's just a roll.
In like a fine shop, someone that who knew what they were doing could probably sell it for like 180. But if you were going to try and hawk it off to somebody, you would be lucky to get half that.
Mm.
You know, it takes a proper merchant to sell them properly.
What is Serena wearing?
She's wearing tattered rags.
Okay.
In the shape of a dress.
I keep the price to myself and throw the silk garments towards her. And say, this is for a lifetime of hell that will hopefully make up for it in some sense.
She smiles and quickly dons the clothing.
Do we see her boobies?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
I'm like, I try to turn away, but then I kind of just look anyway. I'm like, whoo, is he watching?
The Watcher. Sounds epic, but it's just a reference.
Just a tree top.
And then what about the wines?
The wines, there are four of them. Each of them would probably, you could probably get 20 gold for them, selling them.
There's four?
Yeah. They're okay. Nice wine. They're nice elven wine, which has to be imported from pretty far away.
Okay.
Would you guys mind if I kept one of those and sent it to my wife at my village?
There's four of us. I say we each get a bottle. Do with it what you want.
Sounds good to me.
Okay, each of you grab a bottle of wine, weighs 3 pounds.
Is it white or red?
We're still just resting,
rosé.
Right?
Yeah, yeah.
Rosé.
Yeah.
And pretty much the second he hands me the bottle, I bite off the top of it and just chug it.
I do the Nathan Fillion thing where I'm just like...
What?
And then I don't say anything.
It's got some very nice tones to it, but it's gone too quickly. You know, it was a little... had flavors of basil and garlic and...
Neil, Jeff's orc. Can we get the orcus interpretation of this?
The orc interpretation is the flavors are too delicate and it's not strong enough.
Okay.
After I chug it, I kind of look at the bottle for a second and then I just drop it on the ground and stand there.
I look at Karr and say, could you even read that or are you just looking at the pictures, friend?
Yes.
That's about what I expected. How are we good here? Serena, you ready to get out of here? Should we leave this hellhole?
Of course.
Where were the others? Was there other slaves that we were with? I feel like we were with two more.
Yes, you rescued two other slaves as well.
Okay. Did we loot the orc war chief and his companions?
Yes.
You did.
Okay, cool.
I don't know who marked down all that silver and stuff, but I did not.
I took his armor, I marked it down, and I took his axe, which was a one-handed battle axe.
Correct.
Okay.
Back in this room, there is another door you haven't explored through. And then there's the exit.
Ooh, we should look into this door.
I put on my boulder-proof armor and open the door.
The door swings open, revealing an armory on the other side.
Oh, there we go.
Karn runs through it, and if he has to, he actually runs over...
Bless you.
I'd like to detect magic, the whole armory.
He runs over Dante.
Still
but he's...
detect magic?
It's a ritual, so I can just cast it as many times as I want, from what I understand.
Yeah, but it takes 10 minutes.
Yeah, I'm down to cast detect magic on the armory. I'll say, let me study up to see if there is anything magical here.
There is not, but there are many kegs of ale and whiskey, as well as bows, arrows, spears, axes, battle axes, shields, all sorts of stuff. A whole rack of swords, and then some barrels and boxes.
So just generic weapons?
Yeah, just it looks like their armory, where they keep all their backup supplies of everything.
Do you guys want some? I look at the slaves. To protect yourselves.
They shake their heads, and then one of them goes and grabs a sword, and then another goes and grabs a sword, but Serena stays back.
Okay.
Neal, if I wear something heavier than leather, does it impede spellcasting?
I don't know if you're allowed to cast spells in armor. I don't actually know how the spellcasting armor rules work very well. Let's take a look. Spellcasting in armor. Spell. Spellcasting. Armor. 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 Spell in armor. See casting a spell in armor. God, this book is... Casting a spell in armor, page 201. There we go.
I think you can cast in any armor you're proficient in, according to chat.
That sounds about right.
You just need proficiency with the armor to cast spells.
You must be proficient in the armor you're wearing to cast spells, otherwise you're too distracted and physically hampered by your... Yeah. So whatever spell, whatever armor proficiencies you've got is what you can wear. You're okay. A warlock, yeah?
Yes.
What armor proficiencies do you have?
Light.
Okay.
So I don't want anything.
You can take a feat at level 4 to gain proficiency in medium armor if you so desire.
Okay.
Okay. Cool. So that's it. That wraps up this region. You've been through every door except for one. One that you've had a very hard time... Well, I guess you weren't trying to get through it, but as you come back to the main entrance, you come back to this massive stone door flanked by oversized dwarves, and you're reminded that these are indeed dwarven caverns.
Are there... is there, like, a keyhole or anything?
There is a slot for a key. Yes, it does not go all the way through.
Can I try with Thieves' Tool to see if I can open it?
Sure. Get back, my friends. Be careful. Oh, can I detect magic?
Yes.
I detect magic.
You wait another 10 minutes for her to detect magic.
Sure.
And do notice a magical radiance resonating from the door.
I'm moving my character, by the way, just so you know.
This is a magical door, my friends. Beware. Which type of magic?
It does not specify.
Oh, you're going to measure?
Non-disclosed type of magic. Is it strong magic or low-level magic?
It is moderate.
Moderate magic.
Did we rest at all? Did I gain HP back to full HP?
Okay. No, because you took damage from the boulder, so whatever your HP is now is what it is.
I think I have 17 knockdown. Or 17, because I rolled a dice when we rested in there last time.
So I didn't take damage from the boulder, but...
Nope.
Are my thieves' tools metallic?
Yes. Yes, they are.
I guess, can I make a perception roll on the two statues to see if there's anything I need to, like, depress or anything? like a butter.
Give me a perception check. Or investigation check, I'm sorry.
Oh, okay. D20.
While he's doing that...
No.
While he's doing that, I'd like to look into the statues to see if there's anything magical about it.
The statues are non-magical.
Statues are not magical. Maybe I should cast Unseen Servant to see if we can find anything. Maybe I can poke around with it. Or you can send your little man. I look at Dante.
Can he walk through doors?
Yes, he can. Why don't we all stand back and I'll try and have him open the door.
I was afraid of opening it, so by all means.
Everybody stand back with me.
Your imp can walk through doors?
I stand back.
He can't meld through them, but he can open the door if it's
okay.
Not locked.
Gotcha.
Yeah, can it poke around the statues too?
Okay, move your characters to where you want to be when the door's open.
I don't see myself.
You're right there next to Karn.
I just see black.
No, scroll up, it's there.
Reload the page if you can't see
it. Yeah, I really don't
see anything. That's Karn, right?
I'll reload.
Yeah, that's Karn.
Yeah.
I literally don't see anything.
You might have to zoom out. I don't know.
Do you literally not see anything, or is it like
warped? Yeah, it's all black.
Just refresh the page, that's what I just said.
I refreshed and I zoomed out. Not working.
Alright, I can only assume the Jen's right next to the door. Just go ahead.
No.
Yeah, she's under the bolt.
Refreshing again,
directly.
Help.
Jen just backs up to where we are.
Chat, please.
Ryan,
Alright, so yeah, she's back with us, and I send the imp forward to attempt to open this door.
Oh, I got it.
You got it now?
Yeah.
Okay. The imp cannot open the door. The door is locked.
Do we comically see him tugging on it and stuff, though? And then masturbate at the same time?
Yeah, there's this little reddish imp kind of floating around, and it goes up to the door, pushes into it, and then it... pulling on it. And...
I turn towards Dante and ask, how minute of an action can you command this imp to do?
Give me an example of what you mean.
If I open this door... 99% of the way and have him do the last jiggle on the tool, could he do so?
If you tell him pull up on the key, then open the door, I'm sure that would work just fine.
Neil, would that work?
So you want to lockpick it almost all the way and then hand over the tools at the very last moment to an imp and have it finish it off?
Yes.
No. Maybe. Unlikely. I'll give you a shot.
Would it just be, sleight of hand roll followed by like a
communication roll. Yeah, you need to succeed on a sleight of hand modified by your thief tool proficiency if you have it.
Okay.
And then I would need you to make some sort of dex check between you and the imp to properly hand off the tools without it being jinxed or whatever, you know, knocked around, and then the imp would just finish it on its own. So
I will take this. I will
lockpick the check for itself. And then you and the imp make dex checks.
I have an idea. Dante, can you uncast your imp and recast it?
Not here. I need a Brazzers.
Oh, every time you dispel it?
I think you need one to cast it,
correct? Because I know for my pet, for my bat, I can remove and recast it. If it's not killed, it's okay. That's what I understand from my spell.
You can teleport it away to a pocket dimension.
Yeah.
But you can't. You can't dispel it.
No, I mean, I can teleport it away and then I can remake it appear, correct?
Yeah, I mean, you can move it between an extra dimensional space and the current space. But it's the same creature.
So I can't cast it, like, afar from me. It needs to be cast in my hands?
Whatever the spell says.
I don't know. Let me look. Find familiar.
Alright, so what are you guys... Are you... Wait. JP, give me a dex check. No?
No! Let me cast Unseen Servant. I have an idea. I want to cast Unseen Servant on the other side of the door. So that it opens from inside. Can I do that? I think I can.
Go for it. Try it.
I try casting Unseen Servant as a ritual. In the door, like behind the door, like where it would be openable from.
Okay. Your unseen servant does not appear because it is invisible.
Yeah, and then I try to guide it towards opening the door from inside.
Okay. Nothing happens.
Okay, then I tried.
All right, I'm gonna, so sleight of hand to get the door to 99%.
Yes. By the way, you've been standing in this corridor for like half an hour now, fiddling with this door.
Okay.
Okay. 13. That's your.
So you got all health back, you're saying?
No. And okay. Give me a dex check. Dex check, and Dante, give me a dex check for your imp.
A dex saving throw would be the dex check?
No, just a dex check.
So I'm going to roll d20. Dex, no proficiency bonus? Or no, yeah, no proficiency bonus to it?
No, yeah, make it a saving throw. You get proficiency bonus.
Okay. I'm not 16. Sure if there's any.
Yep. 15. So for you. Okay.
So 16 and 15.
All right, so you get these tools in the right place, as near to it as you can tell. You have the imp come in for the last final pull, and the imp jiggles with some things, and then jiggles some more, and then jiggles some more, and all the lockpicks just fall out and scatter on the ground. The imp swirls around in circles, muttering and moaning.
I turn back to the rest. I'm like, did we see a key anywhere? Did anyone pick up anything that could be used as a key?
Did we ever pick up a key?
We checked all the bodies, right, Neil?
Yep. Checked all the bodies.
I turn to Serena and say, have you ever seen what's inside this door? Has it ever been opened?
No. No.
Has it ever spoken
sometimes
about?
I would see the... What's his name? Well, sometimes once, I should say, when they brought me over to the room with the other slaves. I saw the captain holding that glass ball up to the door, but didn't seem like he made any progress.
Oh. I hold a glass ball up.
It looks like a glass ball.
Yeah, I guess I need a command word, huh? I can't, like, try to activate it mentally and be like, glass ball, I command you to open the door right now.
Do you try that?
Yeah, saying that in my mind.
It doesn't do anything.
Okay. Well, it doesn't work.
What is the door made of?
Yeah, what is the door made of?
Stone. Through and through.
Is there any opening on the wall? Like, any aeration vents? Any small holes? Is there a is the door all the way up to the ceiling and the wall completely filled?
Uh-huh. The door is from floor to ceiling, and you can't even see cracks on the side. This is true dwarven master craftsmanship here.
And there's no cracks even at the bottom?
Nope.
Okay.
Are there any carvings or runes?
Yes.
Like hieroglyphics.
There are intricate carvings and runes in dwarven scattered all over the door.
Does anyone speak dwarven? Serena?
No.
Perhaps you have a hidden talent?
No. I'm a useless NPC.
Honest!
Maybe we should try to find out more information about this location. Maybe people in town know about it. Maybe it's known in the area. I can investigate the orb. We could come back.
My fear of spreading information is that more people will know and more people try to open it.
But if I just try to go find information about the orb and look around the library and try to find more stuff about it.
I don't see us coming back here for any reason. We're done here pretty much except for the
door. There are these doors. It's magical. There must be something very important in there. And I feel like we have the key with the orb.
I don't feel like messing with the magical door. I already opened a door here and a rock fell. Who knows what's going to come out of this one.
So there is one other option. We could try to brute force through.
That's made of dwarven... handiwork. I don't
think the door is, but the walls around the door are not.
Karn, could you break through it?
No.
The walls look pretty sculpted too. The whole place looks like it's a dwarven cavern. It's not a natural cave.
Right.
Pretty impressive looking. That said,
well, I think it's pretty smart, to be honest. The walls are not magical.
I mean, even with that being the case, Neil, I take out my dynamite, and I'm going to put it...
in the hole.
I just speak up and say, we can come back here if we find a way to open this, but I'm not going to try to lockpick that door and have something crazy happen on any form or level. So I think we're done here. We got the jade. We can go back.
What if I cast Mage Armor on you and maybe Shield, if that's possible?
Magic with other magic doesn't... I'm not comfortable with that.
Let me just try with the wall for a minute.
Can I cast the Frost Ray on the rocks? I feel like it would make them easier to break, but maybe not. Doesn't cold help break shit? Maybe.
Sure. It can.
You freeze something.
Okay, so I try to pre-freeze the area where Dante wants to break shit.
What are you trying to break, Dante?
It's not letting me see more when I move my character down.
I think because I have a torch.
Yes, you need someone with a source of light.
Oh, okay. Who has the torch?
I move down a little bit.
Okay. I want to get to where it appears the door ends and the stone wall part of the cavern begins.
Okay, so the door kind of slides straight up and down, it seems, or maybe it's back and forth. Either way, it's just kind of like a door that runs floor to ceiling, and then the width of the doorway, and then it's behind these just slabs that come out. So that's your door frame.
So just outside of that, okay. I want to just Eldritch Blast the side of the door.
Okay, so that would be like right here, right door. Where the door frame kind of runs behind the right. Dwarven statue.
Sure.
Okay. Can I pre-freeze it? I feel like the freeze and then the hot would be good.
You can cast Ray of Frost, but it's not cold enough to freeze the stone solid.
All right, then whatever, I guess. Well, I still do it.
Okay. Why not? You Ray of Frost it.
Yeah.
Here. Dante, okay. You Eldritch
then
Blast it.
I step back.
Yes. I'll Eldritch Blast it, let's just say, 10 times.
Okay.
Casual 10.
So 45 minutes later, since you guys got back to this door, you guys are standing there. Dante is slightly out of breath from Eldritch Blasting over and over again.
Eldritch Blast. Yeah, Eldritch Blast.
The stone seems singed and blackened by the explosive force of the magic on it, but otherwise the stone is intact.
So I walk through the hole that's created by the Eldritch Blast.
Yep. You can't seem to find a way past this door for the time being.
I told you, magic doesn't trump magic.
Yes, it does. What else trumps magic if it's not magic?
The key. Which we don't have.
Yeah, like the orb.
Is there a shape to the keyhole or anything like that, Neil? Is it just a little hole?
It's a rectangular notch that just goes in.
Okay.
I think the orc had that because he didn't know how to open this. Was hoping that orb would tell him how to.
That sounds like a very reasonable observation. Whether or not it is true.
I don't think anyone knows how to open this door. We did meet some dwarves the other day. Perhaps we can ask around in town discreetly. And if they do say anything, well, we'll just have to deal with them if they do. I think we're done here for now, though.
We'll have to figure something else out.
Is there a nearby... Let's go to the nearby city, and I shall look into this orb.
Well, we gotta turn this jade in, of course, get our money.
Okay, so you guys exit the tunnel back out into the forest, and you see the sun is just coming up over the eastern forest, over the east side of the... Wait a minute, no. The sun is coming up behind you guys over the mountain and is just starting to sprinkle sunlight through the mountain peaks. Would you all please give me perception checks?
All right.
Yes.
Five.
25. Holy shit, Amos. You're just breaking everything today.
17!
Hang on, hang on.
11.
Mine's really good.
Nice.
So,
start with me, Neil. I pretty much see everything that's happening.
Karn,
before
you start plodding along forward, and your feet hit wood, and you're just happily plodding along.
You're okay. Happy to be outside.
Dante, you're right behind him. Mr. Varnoosh, there's something that feels a little bit off to you as you walk forward. You're not sure what it is. But Amos, you've got it. The sun, instead of being behind you, is all of a sudden on your right. and you're standing on a bridge, and you don't remember crossing a bridge to get here. And you look around, and you are in a very, very different place. There is no mountain behind you. The sun is coming up far, far to your right side. There is a slightly covered bridge that you are crossing through. A river runs beneath it in a forested, swampy area. And I think that is where we will take our first break.
Your sky's frozen, Neil, in the most glorious
light. It's perfect. It freezes in the most perfect places. So yeah.
Lovely. I love that look on me.
It looks good. It looks good. All right, we'll take a break here, and we'll come back, figure out where the fuck we are. So we'll see you guys in just a bit. More Roleplay Solum coming up right after this.